We're going to turn to Acts 2 in just a moment. Hallelujah. But before we do, I've got to build a foundation where I'm going. What I'm about to preach, it's been a year and a half or over since I've even dealt with this topic or even felt led to preach. I was going to preach it last night. Amen. But I had to prophetically, amen, change up last night because of what was taking place in the earth up the East Coast and the storm. And Luke 21:25, God said about a reference, a prophetic parallel to his coming, when it would be nigh at hand, it would be also seen as a sign the seas and the waves would be roaring. Amen. Hallelujah. So some sat home last night in fear and watched the Weather Channel and watched a storm called Matthew. Come on, somebody. And some of us got in the house of God and we opened the book of Matthew and heard what the gospel writer Matthew had to say. And what that storm said, Jesus is coming. Come on, somebody. We didn't just track the storm. We traced the Savior, and he's on the way. Come on, somebody. That's all that storm's about. Hallelujah. Jesus is coming. Hallelujah. And I was going to preach this last night, but I realized early on, amen, that a word spoken in due season, how good is it, Proverbs 15:23. So I knew last night that that word was not for then, it was for tonight. Amen. Glory to God. Now, Ephesians 5:18 says, be ye not drunk with wine, wherein is excess. Somebody say it's a waste. But be ye filled with the Spirit. Yes. Amen. So there is some contrast here between how the world gets drunk and how the church can be drunk in the Spirit. There's some similarities. Now, I'm not advocating getting drunk, come on somebody, with what the world calls spirits. I'm talking about getting drunk in the Spirit, singular, not drunk with spirits. And that name is correctly given to the alcohol they sell in their places, and they advertise it spirits, because it is spirits. Come on, somebody. Alcohol is not a disease, it's a demon. Hello. Glory to God. And Proverbs 20:1 says, wine's a mocker and strong drink is raging, and he that's deceived thereby is not wise. The world has put for years on a dark bottle and a can Budweiser, but according to Proverbs 20:1, God says, Bud, you ain't too wise. You're deceived by that. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. There, you'd be surprised at the social sipping saints that we have modernly in modern Christendom. Come on, somebody. Listen, weren't a drunk when they took a sip. Ever drunk become a drunk just sipping. Anybody breathe. And I'm about to arrest that false doctrine and prosecute it and lock it up. And we're going to, glory to God, bring judgment to it tonight by the Spirit of truth. Praise the Lord God. And we're going to, so to speak, have us a hanging of it. And it's that false doctrine that's crept into the modern church and tells us, well, Jesus in John 2 turned water into wine. So it must be okay, come on somebody, to have a little toddy for the body. Even saints could have a little toddy. Come on, somebody. I'm going to blow that thing up. Come on, somebody. We're going to assassinate that doctrine of demons. Come on, somebody. I'll prove it to you. So I'm not advocating getting drunk in the natural. Come on. I've been there. I've done that. Ain't going back. I used to live there. I slung my hair, played my drums. I made a living at doing that. And it didn't matter how many famous people I met, because I met some. Come on, many. Amen. Doing what I did at the drums in the world when I was a teenager. Amen. And it didn't matter where I went, how big the crowds was, and how big the checks were after you played, and the famous people you got your picture took with. Oh, glory to God. You still had to play honky tonks. You still had to play where the sale of alcoholism. Come on, somebody. And alcohol was promoted. Because the two go together. And so I'm not advocating that by any means. And to prove I'm not, before I preach about getting drunk in the Spirit, singular, capital S, Holy Ghost, I'm going to first expose spirits. Because that's what alcohol is often called. Amen. So is the mineral spirits you, amen, take the paint off your wall with. Lord have mercy. But anyhow, so I'm going to expose the spirits by the Spirit of truth. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. Somebody shout, when you get saved, you don't look for a bottle. Come on, somebody, and have a little toddy every now and then. There ain't no such thing as social, amen, sipping sainthood. Hallelujah. Amen. Listen, in Proverbs chapter 23, and don't go nowhere. We're going to get in Acts 2 for a moment. I'm going to go through this because I want to prove I'm not advocating getting drunk with spirits, but drunk in the Spirit. Amen. There's a difference. But there is some contrast. There is some comparison with the two. So stay with me tonight. And in Proverbs 23:29 said, who hath woes? Somebody say woes. In other words, who has, amen, trouble and misery? Let's go on. Who hath sorrow or upsets? Hallelujah. Who hath contention? Somebody say brawlings, strife and discord and quarreling all the time. Who hath babblings or complaining and weeping and whining and mourning? Amen. Who hath wounds or pains without cause? And who hath redness of eyes? They that tarry long at the wine.
Come on.
They that go to seek mixed wine. I'll show you what that is in a moment. Look not upon the wine when it is red. That means when it has fermented. When it giveth his color. Notice, not its color, but his color. Because fermented alcohol is a him. It's not a it. It's a devil.
Yeah.
It is spirits. Anybody breathing? Breathe. Look at your neighbors and you're missing good times to shout amen. Some of you about 30 behind. Catch up now. Hallelujah. When it giveth its color in the cup, that means when it has fermented. When it moveth itself aright, it's moving. It's like it's alive because it's fermented. It's somebody shout, it's alive. And he called it a him. He didn't call it just an it because it's a spirit, it's a devil. I ain't met nobody that got drunk last night and got hammered and said, my God, our marriage worked out better since we got drunk. Hey, man, boy, our church has just been in a mess lately, so we just all got together and we just had us a party and just got drunk, just got slammed, and boy, our church just got better. Somebody shout, alcoholism ain't never made anybody better. It destroys lives, it destroys homes, it destroys family. Somebody shout, the devil is a liar. He's a father of it, John 8:44. That the devil's a father of the lie, quit being the mama. Go. Verse 32, listen, at last, somebody shout, when the alcohol wears off, it biteth like a serpent. Wow, somebody shout, fermented wine is like a serpent. Ooh, Revelation 20, verse 2 says Satan's an old serpent. This portrait that Proverbs 23 is giving us of strong drink, alcohol, wine, he's showing us it's a devil. It ain't just a drink. It's a devil. Hallelujah. And stingeth like an adder. Stings like a scorpion, like a snake. Come on, somebody. Listen, he said, that I shall behold strange women. Come on, somebody. Amen. Men that get drunk, they start looking around. They start running around. They start playing around when they ain't supposed to be around. With somebody they ain't supposed to be around with.
Amen.
Most all the time, you can find drug abuse and alcohol abuse somewhere where there's infidelity.
Amen.
They go together.
Amen.
Anybody breathe? Breathe. Breathe. Hallelujah. You helped start this last night at the end of the service when you was testifying, Pastor. Amen. How you went to church drunk and got so saved you never touched it again. Amen. Your pastor went to church drunk and got so saved he sobered up and never touched it again. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. It's a devil word. Hallelujah. Amen. And listen, he said, and thine heart shall utter perverse things. People that get drunk will say stuff. If you recorded them, they'll look at it and say, my God, I didn't know I said all that. Somebody say drunk people say stuff they didn't never mean to say.
Right.
Is that me? have, we're in a technology age. Everybody's got a cell phone. Before your local news can film it, it's already been posted on social media. Drunks speak things they didn't mean to say. I've seen people, man, just as calm and collective, and their demeanor was just perfect. Hey, man, and you never heard them say any bad thing, but son, they got a little sloppy, hey, man, in their speech. After they got a little tidy in their body, and you stand there with your jaws open thinking, is that the same person? I ain't believing they talking like that. Somebody shout, that's that devil talking. That's them spirits. They make people say stuff. Perverse things, cursing. Verse 34, yea, thou shalt be as he that lieth down in the midst of the sea, or he that lieth down upon the top of the mast. In other words, this shows a sickness that comes. Somebody say a hangover. Those that tarry long in this wine, somebody shout, they get a hangover. They get sick. Somebody shout, it makes them sick. Verse 35, they have stricken me. Listen what the drunk man said. They have hit me or stricken me, beaten me. And thou say, I was not sick. And they have beaten me, and I felt it not. When shall I awake? I will seek it yet again.
Come on.
He's hooked. When he wakes up after he's been sick, he goes into denial and say, well, I weren't really sick. And he's got to go find it again. He got beat up last night. He got so drunk, but he wakes up. Come on, somebody's fell on the floor. He came and he heard the thought, and he finds somebody. Come on, somebody shout, that's a devil. So I'm not advocating getting drunk in spirits or with spirits, alcohol. Come on, somebody shout, it's a devil. I just proved it to you. It destroys people. It deceives people. It wrecks homes and lives. It's a liquid drug.